Okay, we got some smoke. We got some smoke. We got some.
Y'all gotta
some
stop
smoke.
The wood.
We got some heat. Oh no. Pierre Bournet revealed the truth about him and Playboi Carti. Oh god, I've been seeing a lot of shit with Pierre and Cardi. That's why he's trending on. I like how that's the reason he's trending right now.
Y'all insane. Gotta stop the bullshit with the Cardi.
You know, for the past...
Y'all gotta stop the bullshit with the Cardi.
You know, for the past 4 years, I've been asking, why does it feel so weird between Opium and Pierre? Because we all know how Cardi is with his producers. There's times where you think these dudes that he's working with, he will be locked in with them for a long time because they're making good quality music. Why would you change that up? But we all know that Cardi like to change up his sound a lot, so right. He just goes from producer to producer. For example, the Opium fans don't like to bring up Richie South up no more. There's so many times we thought that producers were locked in with Cardi, but it turns out after a while you just found out he wasn't even really locked in with them for real, and it probably was just for that time specifically. Ever since Cardi had made All Out of Red and Pierre didn't have that much production on there, Opium fans been questioning the whole friendship between Cardi and Pierre. And to me, it wasn't that crazy to know that Cardi and Pierre don't hang out or anything like that, because that's not what we're talking about.
Okay.
It wasn't that crazy to know that Cardi and Pierre don't hang out or anything like that, because that's not what we're talking about. But it's way different when you're not seeing any production or you're not seeing that many signs of them working on their music. And that's been out the window for a long time. There's multiple occasions where you can tell that Opium might have a problem with Pierre. We already know that Keenan and Pierre had their issue a few years back.
They did?
But we found out in 2023 that
I never knew any of this shit.
With Pierre. We already know that Keenan and Pierre had their issue a few years
back. See, I told you Opium was in a... And that shit right now.
Years back.
I didn't know this was even happening, so this is a surprise to me.
2023, that they are on good terms now. Then y'all remember, Opium Baby had a problem years back, but we found out in 2023 that they are on good terms.
Okay, cool.
Now, then y'all remember, Opium Baby had a problem with Pierre too. We was informed that Pierre wasn't allowed to be in a studio with Cardi or something like that because of an issue that they had going on. But I'm gonna be real, a lot of this changed because not too long ago, Pierre actually produced a track for Homicide Gang. So it was still fans out there hoping that Cardi and Pierre are somewhat still connected in some way. But for some reason, the fans still thought there was beef going on, because if you're not seeing them on social media or nothing like that, or you're not seeing them interact with each other as much, y'all know how to fan.
Why is my quality tweaking again? Like, gang.
Sorry, they automatically gonna assume that there's beef going on. And it's only been getting worse for people that think that way, because Cardi don't ever show signs of working with Pierre again. Because we all been seeing that lately, Cardi is going to a different direction with his sound. And I'll be seeing times where Pierre will go live or something like that, and there will be tons of people in the comments just keep asking the same thing over and over. Yo, are you still cool with Cardi? Do you got some production on I Am Music? And it be happening so much that when Pierre don't respond to it, it only make you think he don't even care to talk about Cardi no more, or they just not cool no more. But what if I told you today he actually spoke on him and Cardi friendship? So let's check this out. All right, so the tweet say Pierre talks about beef with Cardi.
Y'all gotta stop the bullshit with the Cardi, man. We locked in for life. I want y'all, man.
People just thinking too much.
That's all I'm gonna say. Locked in for life.
I mean, also, like,
it really
feel like the artist that has, like, said beef with these people, or the other way around, the producer has beef with said artist. I feel like the artist or the producer kind of gives, or the artist and the artist kind of give the fans their way of thinking that the people have beef if they don't talk about it. They only open up more opportunities for the fans to guess whatever the fuck they want or assume whatever the fuck they want. So it's like with Yachty and Caribou, it ain't take much for Yachty to kind of speak about it. I don't know if he was forced to by himself, or like fans was getting to a point where they were just talking about it too much. I don't know what the fucking case was, but that, it kind of felt like he was coming from the heart. It didn't feel like fans was forcing him to come out. Also, because it had been like a week for Yachty's situation, but this I ain't even know about, so I don't know what the case was. But I mean, you know, if fucking artists and producers don't talk about the shit that's going on behind the scenes, you give niggas opportunities to speak about it and cloud their judgment and their fucking opinion, you know? So, moral of the story, fucking talk about the shit before it gets to a point where niggas can assume shit. That's good to hear something like that. Like,
but why am I looking at the comments? Somebody talking about something. He's coping, laughing my ass. Opium don't f*** with him no more. It's facts. Lone ain't giving his number when they linked up at the club. Laughing emoji. Now, I don't know what he talking about, but if that's true, y'all can confirm that. I don't know. Y'all thought it always made sense, and it was never a problem that Cardi would step away from Pierre because he wanted to evolve his sound. He wanted to change it up a bit. That makes sense. I do feel like Cardi should at least try to work with Pierre more. It never made sense why they would beef with each other. You know what I'm saying? Cardi wouldn't be where he is without Pierre, and Pierre wouldn't be where he is without Cardi. It was one of the craziest duos we ever seen. Like, for real. And they brung a whole different sound, a whole different vibe, a whole different swag to the game. So it never seemed to make sense why people would try to put them against each other. Yeah, obviously dudes are gonna bump
the you know, back then Cardi. I just, you know, I know like that would, you know, I know that'll never be you know, I know that'll never be a thing again, but you know, it just hurts a little bit, you know, when you realize it. What the fuck could I play from back then? Like, this type of shit? Like, you know? Damn, is this like... Damn. Made it this far. I like how made it this far is still getting leaked to this fucking day. It's insane. It's like, yeah, I fought with the, you know? I fought with the, you know? I fought with the 2024 Cardi, but like, you know, this shit. Niggas shitted on that album too hard. Before I get copyrighted, but you know, this shit, like, bro.
They came with like a king.
LeBron.
All of these nuts in my jeans. Yeah. Alexander, I'm a queen. Yeah.
Diamonds,
they looking like ice.
This.
Out with the hole like I'm ice. Stack on my cash, I got hype.
This is what put me on ASAP. But anyway. I'll never get that Cardi again, sadly. You know. Anyway.
Bump heads. I really doubt that Cardi just don't talk to Pierre no more. I don't think that's the case. Even if Pierre not doing that much production for Cardi, he probably might still be doing it for him. I mean, Pierre was on a whole lot of red. But I'm very curious to what Cardi gonna do with I Am Music, because him and Pierre got so many tracks they ain't released yet, and it would be very well if they just put them on the next album. Right. And it's crazy because some of Cardi's best snippets be with Pierre. Like, I'm not even trolling about that. But y'all let me know how y'all feel about this whole situation. Y'all actually think they locked in? Like,
I stopped listening to Cardi's snippets because nothing ever dropped. So it's just like, I didn't even give my whole soul into the Cardi snippets because none of them ever came out. So, you know. And that is where we're going to end. Still want to react to another video actually after this. So, yeah. Shout out Duty. I didn't even know that this beef was happening. So, shout out Duty for doing us the info.